सीरियस मैट्रिक्स टाइप क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम IITJEE एडवांस्ड 2010. यू आर गिवन मेनी रेजिस्टेंसेज, कैपेसिटर्स एंड इंडक्टर्स. दीज आर कनेक्टेड टू अ वेरिएबल DC वोल्टेज सोर्स और एन AC वोल्टेज सोर्स ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी 50 हर्ट्ज इन डिफरेंट वेज एज शोन इन कॉलम 2. व्हेन अ करंट I, स्टेडी स्टेट फॉर DC और RMS फॉर AC फ्लोज थ्रू द सर्किट, द करस्पॉन्डिंग वोल्टेज V1 एंड V2 आर रिलेटेड एज शोन इन कॉलम 1. Okay, so we are given two columns. In column 2, we are given a circuit. In column 1, we are given certain values and we have to just match them. Okay, so in these questions, generally I like to go from column 2 to column 1 because the column 2 is generally the situation, condition or a circuit like that. So I will solve these circuits one by one and try to match the options from column 1. Okay, so first of all, let's look at the first circuit. So we have a DC battery, an inductor and a capacitor. For steady state, there is no voltage across inductor and DC circuit, and for capacitor, there is no current crossing. So for DC battery, the current will be zero because of this capacitor. I will be zero, V1 will be zero, and V2 will be equal to V. Okay, now let's look at the options. So option A says I is not equal to zero, option B also says the same, option D also says the same. So these will be wrong. Only option C will be correct. Okay, V1 equal to 0, V2 equal to V. That's what we have proved. Then look at the second circuit. Again, we have a DC battery, inductor and a resistor. For DC circuit in steady state, inductor has no voltage. So this will be 0 and therefore this will be equal to V. I will be how much? V by R. So that will be V by 2 ohms. Now, I is not equal to 0, correct. V1 is proportional to I, but V1 is constant, 0, so this will be wrong. I is not equal to 0, V2 greater than V1, V2 is greater than V1, correct. So we have B. Then V1 is equal to 0, V2 is equal to V, again correct. So we put C. And I is not equal to 0, V2 is proportional to I, so V2 is equal to V. And V2 will be equal to IR, right? From this equation, V2 or V is equal to IR. So V is proportional to current, right? So option D is also correct. Now coming to third circuit, we have an AC voltage source. Now we have an inductor and a resistor. So the frequency is 50 Hertz, right? Frequency is 50 Hertz. So first of all, we need to find the reactance of the inductor. So XL will be how much? Omega L. So omega will be 2 pi times frequency 50 times 6 into 10 power minus 3. 6 into 10 power minus 3 is the inductance. So this will come out to be equal to, so it will be equal to 6 pi by 10, and there will be roughly 1.8 ohms. So since XL is greater than the resistance, so V1 will be equal to IXC and V2 will be equal to IR. Okay, so XC is roughly 1.8, so this is 1.8I and this will be 2I. Okay, resistance is 2. Now let's look at the options. So I is not equal to 0, correct. V1 is proportional to I. V1 is proportional to I, yes. So A is right. Then I is not equal to 0, V2 greater than V1. So V2 is 2I, V1 is 1.8I. So option B is also correct. Then option C, V1 equal to 0, but V1 is not 0. So C is not correct. I is not equal to 0, V2 is proportional to I. So V2 is equal to 2I, so V2 is proportional to I. So this is also correct. So we get ABD. Then for this circuit now, we have an inductor and a capacitor. So for the inductor, we have already calculated that XL is equal to 1.8 ohms roughly. Now we need to calculate the XC. So XC will be 1 by omega C. So 1 by 2 pi times 50 times 3 into 10 power 6. So I'll get 10 power 6 in numerator. Okay. So this will be equal to, so this will be equal to 10 power 4 by 3 pi. Okay, and they'll be roughly equal to how much? 3 pi could be roughly equal to 10, so this will be equal to 1000 ohms. Okay. So voltage V1 will be I into XL, that is 1.8 I, and voltage V2 will be 1000 I. Okay. Now let's look at the options. I is not equal to 0, V1 proportional to I. Correct. V1 will be 1.8 I, so option A is correct. I is not equal to 0, V2 greater than V1, so V2 is equal to 1.8 I, V1 is equal to 1.8 I and V2 is equals to 1000 I. correct. 1000 I, and this is 1.8 I, so V2 is more than V1, so option B is correct. Then option C says V1 equal to 0, obviously wrong. Then again I is not equal to 0, V2 is proportional to I, so V2 is proportional to I, correct. So we get option D also correct again over here. Now coming to the last circuit. Okay, so we have the resistor and the capacitor in series with each other connected to an AC source. So the resistor is already 1000 ohms, but for the capacitor we calculated XC to be 1000 ohms, but actually this was an approximation. XC is actually 10 power 4 by 3 pi, which will be 10 power 4 by 9.3 roughly. Okay, so this will be more than 1000 ohms. This is slightly more than 1000 ohms, we could say 1001 ohms. Okay, then V1 will be equal to 1000 I and V2 will be equal to 1001 I. okay, so V2 is greater than V1. Now I is not equal to 0, V1 is proportional to I. Yes, I is not equal to 0, V2 more than V1. Yes, V2 is 1001 I while V1 is 1000 I, so B is correct. C says V1 equal to 0, obviously no. I is not equal to 0, V2 proportional to I. Yes, option D will also be correct. So this is your final solution.